disappointed in the result yesterday. Taking on a really good football team, we were right there until the very end, and still, we're all of the opinion that we did not play our best game yet, and we're still chasing that. Great opportunity for our team this week. Starting divisional play, first to six opportunities. These road division games are very, very critical to the overall landscape of your season. Our whole season, in my opinion, is still out in front of us with 12 games to go, including half of those being in the division. Guys are back at work today, and we'll continue to chase improvement every single day and continue to try to hone in on the areas that we have to improve, which are very obvious as of this point. Just give you guys a little injury update. Justin's still going through the evaluation process on that hamstring strain. I'll keep you guys posted on what that timeline may look like and how his availability will be for this week or moving forward. Our kid Levin's had a leg contusion. We'll see how he progresses. Hope to have him throughout the week. And then Lewis should be back and pretty close to a full workload of progress force. Joining us active on the game day roster this week. And then as far as Nick Mullins, we decided to hold him out and continue to evaluate his low back injury, and we'll be kind of assessing that over the next couple of days, whether we decide to make a roster move there or get him based upon the timeline of what that looks like to get him healed and see where that goes. I think there'll probably be a couple different opinions on it, but we got to get the MRI of it, take a look and find out exactly what it is, where it is, if there's any other factors that go into it, and determine what the best decision for him to get him back to, 100% as fast as possible. But he's down today. He obviously is one of the most ultra competitors I've ever met. Trying to go back in the game like he was yesterday. So we're going to have to medically make a good decision and help, kind of almost protect him from himself a little bit in a way where we got to take care of him and get him back. It probably wasn't going to be possible, but he was trying to figure out a way. Yeah, I think they based upon strength and kind of the initial diagnosis, the best they can do with a soft tissue injury like that. It was determined that we would move it off. Well, I think it's hard when you're kind of a competitor yourself and you know that. You start asking yourself the question: at what percent is having him out there still give us, the best possible chance of winning? That's not the way to go about it with a player of that kind of importance to our team, organization, everything we want to do. The goal now is to get him healthy as fast as possible and give him the great resources and treatment that Tyler, Uriah, and our group offer.
With him or with him in general, do you look at it as something where a player has to be 100%?
Yeah, I don't know that. That's a really good question, and I think it maybe a lot of times depends on what that player's job may be. Wide receiver run and the way he runs, the way he opens up. Every single play it seems like he's running full speed, scoring off the ball. To be determined on all that, but we're going to do what's best for Justin. Make sure we give him the treatment and the plan that in the big picture positive.
Are you optimistic for this week? Have you been given reasons to be optimistic?
I have not really been given reasons either way yet. Just kind of got done talking to the team a little bit ago. Those guys are in meetings now. We'll get with our medical staff and kind of work through kind of those cases. Yeah, I think, I believe we have 12 giveaways now, minus 9 on the turnover differential. not known we've lost the four teams that were in the playoffs last year, but our minus 10 point differential that tells you that you're a possession away from, you know, all these teams. And what do one or two or three of these teams look like with an opening drive touchdown against the Chargers, with an opening drive touchdown yesterday against the, you know, the defending world champs, the teams that you can't give things to, and we've got to stop giving away the football. And that's been emphasized and will continue to be emphasized and whatever we have to do, but there is nothing more important than the Minnesota Vikings has the football in their hands right now in any phase. And if we can get our hands on it defensively, the same thing goes for them as well. I think it's just, that's got to be the starting point for us leaving the locker room on game day every time we get back on the plane to go home after our game this week. It's that mentality that there's nothing more important than that. I think one of the factors really, specifically talking about yesterday, is that's off of an 18-yard gain. And there's only so many players down the field in that area. TJ's against the Chargers was off of an 8-yard completion on 37 in the high red zone, where we kind of, by design, dispersed people around the field to try to make sure that we got eligibles for Kirk in zone one-man coverage. So I think that's part of it. But yes, we're continuing to emphasize getting, just like we do on defense, getting 11 purple hats to the ball. We want to see finishing strength out of everybody to have more population at the ball, not only to help Vikings, picking up Vikings after a game at 17 or 18 on the first play of the game, but to be there in the case of emergency. And my hope is we don't need to rely on that here too much moving forward, but what a positive was, we played the next 59 and a half minutes or so without putting the ball on the ground, but it was a critical play. Really started being exactly how you don't want to start against that football.
Kevin, sure, any loss bugs you, but how much does it bug you even more that you're losing all these home games?
Yeah, it's tough. You're exactly right. They all hurt you, but playing at U.S. Bank Stadium is such a genuine opportunity for us to have a home field advantage. I believe we have the best fans in the NFL. We have our game day environment is second to none, both from what our staff puts on there, but also what our fans bring. And quite honestly, that's one of the most disappointing parts about it, is not winning in that setting, knowing that how important it is to us as a team to win football games at home. We're going to get some other opportunities this year and continue to work, whether we're on the road or at home, to get it done. I think it's it's one of those things where kind of some of the ones that really glaring jump out was the last play against the Chargers, early third down yesterday, some balls down the field. I think it's kind of the nature of maybe how we're being defended a little bit. He's a focal point for the defense. But, we've got to continue to try to get him in some spaces and maybe throw the ball in some places where, we don't have to, always make him, extend. And he's working the middle a lot as a tight end. And that's kind of, it's tough sometimes. But DJ, the first one, I'll tell you, maybe you can finish a couple more plays. I can call some better plays for him. Sure, can put him in some spots. Listen, throws, looks collected. Improvement for sure.
Kirk was talking a little bit yesterday about felt like his ball was high quite a bit. Mechanically, as a quarterback, are there things that you work on in different phases? Obviously, more varied than that. But are there things that you work on to set it down?
I think it's just base balance, body position, and then if you do get sped up, either by the rush or just by the early on field of the game, trying to get on top of the football and finish your throws in a way where they're not high, kind of high meters, really tough catches no matter where you are. And I think as the game kind of went on, he settled in a little bit more. But kind of the way the coverages will present themselves, playing a little more, looking for the quarters, there are going to be some underneath defenders that you feel, and you really got to try to locate the ball I'm very confident in that group. I think Jordan had a huge team yesterday. Could have been even, you know, bigger, quite honestly. There were some offs out there for him, and he'll continue to thrive. The big thing for him now is KJ and really the rest of our receiving core, our tight end group, CJ as a fullback, and how can we continue to activate a lot of the things when a lot of our pass game is really built around so much coverage being deployed to Justin. We got a lot of double teams yesterday, a lot of physical play at the line of scrimmage for him that quite frankly opens some things up for some other guys. Whether people decide to play a little bit more straight out or true, how we run it, maybe it's looks that, quite frankly, we don't get a whole lot. All that will really kind of work together to marry the run in the past, and we've got to find a way to find the best matchups with the team on third down and the red zone to try to score. But I'm very confident in our group. I felt pass pro yesterday. For the most part, against a pretty elite group, getting after the quarterback is pretty good. Where Jones got home pretty quick there. But quick game, you call him that open. Just kind of extension of the run game, good ball out type thing. But I thought for the most part, though, those guys up front really used a lot of the help we gave them on the edges. The backs were great, kind of internally helping. And that'll help those matchups go win when Kirk's got time to really see the whole thing.
When it comes to Addison,
I think the thing that jumped out really yesterday was just how fast he was running. I don't know if you guys felt that as well, but it's just no matter what he was doing, he was running. He was going, getting on edges, running away from coverage, getting his touchdown. Just a great example of playing fast and getting to the void. Not necessarily having it present itself. He jumps out at you, the snap always going to run to that location. Kirk knows he's going there, Jordan knows he's going, but how fast he did it, avoiding contact, I think he's improving, avoiding some of the physical play that young players tend to get, in the first few weeks in the NFL, throwing off their rhythm and timing. He has some good releases yesterday, and then just catch transition. He's working out play there early on in the game. Really elite level route on kind of a snag route, catch transition, gets his 5, 6, 7 more, and catch on the third long down the red zone going the other way. And he's getting maximum yards out of the catch, elite catch, hands catches, so many things to like about receiver play. He does so naturally, and he's just improving every opportunity he gets. And really excited about Joey. Lucky to have him.